Hello there! I just finished preparing a blank system for this tutorial. My name is Peter Lemmens. In this tutorial, my very first one on YouTube, I will show you how you can create a portable version of Ghidra on Microsoft Windows that includes a Java development kit as per requirements. This is the long version of the tutorial. I also created a shorter version for those who know their way around already. You can find that link here. In this version, I will show you four different kinds of Java. Some download sites turned out to be annoying. I always appreciate constructive feedback on my videos. Thank you. Let's get on it. Okay, folks, we start by creating a folder named Ghidra, or is it Ghidra? I don't know. How do you pronounce this? Anyways, let's put this on the left side of my screen. Now I open my favorite browser. Let's go to the website of Ghidra. I always forget what the website name is. Silly, but yeah. It increases the popularity of Google. Let's download this zipped beast and open it. In the meantime, let's take a look together at the installation guide. Let's go to the installing Ghidra section. What happened? Oh yes, the download finished, that's what happened. Let's extract it then. Okay, in the meantime we resume reading the installation guide. Here, we see Ghidra requires a supported version of a Java runtime and development kit on the path to run. Remember this, guys? Okay, we have adopt OpenGDK and Amazon Koreto. Let's open those. In a tab, of course. Okay, what will we download here? Okay, we will filter the operating system for Windows and we are running a 64-bit. And then we will take the zip file, I assume. Yes, GDK. That one we take. In the meantime, we go download the Amazon one. Okay, this space is a bit confusing. Linux, where is Windows? We have to scroll down here. Okay, here we have it, GDK zip. We will download that one. Okay, we'll close the tabs now, we don't need them anymore. And let's go find another version, because we also have Oracle and the OpenGDK or OpenJava or whatever it is called. Let's see. GDK GA, no idea what this one is. Let's download that one. Commercial build of GDK 15 from Oracle. Interesting. Okay, this seems to be easy to download. Congrats for that. Okay, we're done on this page. Let's go back. And then we go find the other one. This is release notes. We don't need that. Let's search for a download of GDK 11 instead. Okay, what do we find here? What do we have here? Scroll, 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 scroll. Terrible. Okay, compressed archive. That's the one we take. Accept. Okay. Download. What's that? Sign on? No, no. I'm not gonna create an account. No, not gonna happen. Let's try version 15. Yes, that works. Okay, scroll. And here we have it. GDK 15. Accept. Everything has been downloaded. Perfect. Show all downloads. So here we have an overview of all the things we have downloaded. So we only need one version of the GDK. And we're done. Let's review the installation again. Blah 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 blah. Okay, if you want Ghidra to launch a specific version, blah 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 blah. Java home override in properties file. Okay, we're not gonna do that. We don't need it for our portable version. Let's open a file explorer, go to the downloads. Okay, I move it to the right side so you can follow easier. Let's pick one. I will take the Oracle one. That's the second one, the GDK minus 15. Normally those files are inside the folder, inside the zip archive, so dum-ti-dum-dum-dum. After this copying is done, we will create our batch file. This batch file will ensure that Ghidra can find our Java environment. Okay, I will put everything in full screen now and I will launch Notepad. Super fast typer. Let me explain what this batch file does. The first line, it will prevent the batch file from outputting what it is currently executing. The second two lines, they will store the current state so that the state can be modified and can be restored at the end. Then we have set Java underscore home. That line will set that environment variable to the directory the batch file is in. In our case, the C double point backslash Ghidra directory with GDK minus 15 appended to it. The path equals line will ensure that Ghidra can find and launch java.exe. Then we will launch the Ghidra run batch file from Ghidra itself. After Ghidra has done its job, we will restore our state, and the last two lines will delete those temporary environment variables. Let's save it as a batch file. And we're done. Let's test it. Ta-da-da-da-da-da. Yes. It launched, so we can close Ghidra again, because for this tutorial we don't really need it. Now we can create a shortcut on our desktop. Let's fix the icon. And the name, of course. Yeah, duh. Where is it? Where can we... Here, I don't know. Ghidra? Nope. Server, maybe? Support. Oh yes, here we have it. A nice icon. Apply, or we can press OK, whatever. Let's test it again for our ego. Of course, we can always trust on Microsoft Windows. Okay, we're done. But not yet. I will copy the Ghidra directory to USB drive and then I will plug that USB drive into another system and I will launch Ghidra. Come on. Copying this is really slow. I don't know why, probably because there are too many files. It's a disaster. Eject and we move to a new system. Remember, this system does not have Java or Ghidra installed. It's also a clean system. Let's copy and paste this. Why is copying so many files so slow? I don't understand again. And there we have it, Ghidra. Does it work? It did. Okay, perfect, we're done. So this concludes my tutorial on how to create a portable Ghidra installation which includes a Java environment. Which environment you choose is entirely up to you. Personally, I will never go for the Amazon one. The OpenGDK from java.net was the easiest one to download. So yeah. You can now always have Ghidra with you so you can reverse engineer code anywhere, anytime. Have fun and don't stop learning.